Every day we have a choice of how that day is going to go. My face is red because it's windy out. It's back to winter. Yes, still drinking coffee. Every day something's gonna happen, whether good or bad. So it's how we address that or how we react to that situation. If it's bad, we usually let that control our whole day. Of course, we want every day to be positive, but negative things are going to happen in our lives every day, and it's how we react to those things. We need to, if something bad happens, we need to block that out and be appreciative of what's good in our lives. Appreciative, thankful, because one bad thing can ruin your whole day, and we need to not let that control us. I think that's the thing with living in New England. We have weather, we have winter, and it usually is supposed to last for a few months, but sometimes it hangs around for a little bit longer, sort of outworn its welcome. So I think we need to embrace whatever it is. Like, if it is winter and it's hanging on for too long, just enjoy that day. Because if we just go, oh, winter, oh, snow, then that's going to ruin our whole day. And not let barking ruin your day. He can bark all he wants. So that's why I say we have choices every day. We have choices if something bad happens and how we're going to react to that. We can just let it roll off our shoulders and just be like, that's not gonna bother me. And it's easier said than done, because I've been the victim of, oh, something bad happened, I'm gonna let that ruin my day. And then if we choose to get over that really quickly, then better things can come our way. Just kind of like leave that in the past, and then something great will happen probably right after that. So what's going on today? I'm gonna try to go to the gym because I haven't been in a while. And I want to do a drawing stream later today on Twitch, Hungry for the number 4 art, and then follow me on Facebook and on YouTube, the channel here. I will be going live, doing some live drawing.
It's really cool sort of like stand that allows me to prop this up, and you can put this on your lap and draw if you're sitting in a chair or something like that, but you can also put it on a table too, your art. And then you can also put an iPad on there if you wanted to. I'm also working on this art piece of Walt Disney, referencing from this piece over here, drawn by a different artist. And then here's what I've drawn so far. Still working on it. Take a little bit more time. Got a lot of hours into it, but this is on a program called Procreate.
$5 or $10 program. I think I bought it when it was like $5, but even if it's $10, it's like Photoshop, but you can use, where's the Apple Pencil? I just had it and lost it. Oh, it's right here. So you can use the Apple Pencil. Any stylus will work with it too. I think it's a great program, so check that out if you have an iPad. This is an iPad Pro, so it's like 12.9 inches, so it's a little bit bigger than. They have two pros. I think one's like a 10, and then have a regular one, but I like the size of this one. That's it for me. Like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll talk to you guys later. Peace.